In this video, we'll go through how we can display search results inside the header search overlay, using Bricks' new search filter and other filters to customize the experience. Here we have a common header layout, a logo, a notification bar at the top, and a simple menu. Let's open up the header template. We'll first add the header search element. By default, we have the search form that opens over the top of the header. Let's add some padding to align the form with the header content. The default behavior is that we click the search icon, type in the search term, press enter, and are redirected to a search results page. Instead of this, we want to take advantage of Bricks' new filters to allow the results to show up dynamically inside our search overlay. For both header overlay and below header options, we have a new live search tab. Enabling this will allow us to nest elements inside of the header search element, so we can build a custom layout for our search results. We can see the default input has been removed. We can add in our elements here. First, we need the filter search element to replace the standard search input. The next step is to build the layout for the results. We first have to add a block. This is the search results block that will appear when the user starts to type. And then a container. This will help align with the page content. We can see the structure taking shape. If we add a background and shadow to the container, it'll be easier to see. Now we have the overall container, we can build any layout for the results inside. We'll add a block for creating a grid. And for the results themselves. This'll be where the query loop is, and where we need our content for each result found. We'll add the same 20-pixel padding here to align with the header content. Let's add this padding to the container instead. If we view on the front, we can see how the layout will look as the user uses the search form. Let's implement the Ajax search behavior. All filters need to target this result element. And then on our result element, we just need to enable Ajax search. We can choose to limit the search to specific post types. We'll set this to 3, and then add pagination later. Enable the live search, and then provide the ID of our search results block. And lastly, we'll add a loader. Let's add some pagination in case there are lots of results. We can do the same thing with the below header option. If we wanted to create a full width overlay, we can just style the block instead of the container. Let's go back to the previous layout and add in some more elements. We could make this grid 3 columns and add in some featured images. When building a layout, we can disable the Ajax search option, so we can see more posts inside of the builder. Let's add a heading. We could also add any filters to help narrow down the results. Once we're happy with the layout, we can re-enable the Ajax search option. One last thing we could do is take advantage of the new search term filter to show the search term in the heading. And there we have our live search results inside of our header overlay.